Okay, everybody close your eyes. I want you to raise your hand if you have ever had a girl say something bad about you behind your back. Open your eyes. Now, close your eyes again. And this time, I want you to raise your hand if you have ever said anything about a friend behind her back. Open them. There's been some girl-on-girl crime here. Okay, so what we could do today is a couple exercises to help you express your anger in a healthy way. Let's start over here.
Miss Norbury had us confront each other directly about the things that were bothering us. And it seemed like every clique had its own problems.
You've been acting really stuck up ever since you switched to short fielder, and Dawn agrees with me.
Dawn?
Don't drag me into this. I'm pitching tomorrow.
That's all my yen kek without my eye. My jiggy and the might and jack down your hunt my.
Okay. Good. Can I just say that we don't have a clique problem at this school? And some of us shouldn't have to take this workshop because some of us are just victims in the situation?
That's probably true. How many of you have ever felt personally victimized by Regina George?
Good. Okay, who's next? Who's next? Cady. Do you have anything you want to own up to?
Yes. No.
You never made up a rumor about anybody?
Just that you sell drugs.
No. Nothing you want to apologize for?
I couldn't apologize to Ms. Norbury without getting blamed for the whole burn book.
No. I'm really disappointed in you, Cady. Okay, so we're all here because of this book, right? Well, I don't know who wrote this book, but you all have got to stop calling each other sluts and whores. It just makes it okay for guys to call you sluts and whores. Who here has ever been called a slut? Okay, everybody up.
Miss Norbury had us write out apologies to people that we'd hurt in our lives.
Alyssa, I'm sorry I called you a gap-toothed bitch. It's not your fault you're so gap-toothed.
Gretchen, I'm sorry I laughed at you that time you got diarrhea at Barnes & Noble, and I'm sorry I told everyone about it. And I'm sorry for repeating it now.
Huh? Laura, I don't hate you because you're fat. You're fat because I hate you.
I just wish we could all get along like we used to in middle school. I wish that I could bake a cake made out of rainbows and smiles, and we'd all eat and be happy.
She doesn't even go here.
Do you even go to this school?
No. I just have a lot of feelings.
Okay, go home.
Sharon, I think you're doing a great job.
Thanks. I feel like I'm getting through.
I'm sorry that people are so jealous of me, but I can't help it that I'm popular.
Oh, my God. Oh, geez. Okay, walk it off. Walk it off.
Okay. That hurt.
They're okay. They're okay. Oh, boy. Okay, who's next? Who's next? Keep it going.
Oh, my God. It's her dream come true, diving into a big pile of girls.
Okay, yeah. I've got an apology. So, I have this friend who is a new student this year, and I convinced her that it would be fun to mess up Regina George's life. So I had her pretend to be friends with Regina, and then she would come to my house after and we would just laugh about all the dumb stuff Regina said. And we gave her these candy bar things that would make her gain weight, and we turned her best friends against her. And then, Cady? You know my friend Cady. She made out with Regina's boyfriend and then convinced him to break up with her. Oh, God, and we gave you foot cream instead of face wash. God, I am so sorry, Regina. Really, I don't know why I did it. I guess it's probably because I've got a big lesbian crush on you. Suck on that!
Regina, wait, I didn't mean for that to happen.
To find out that everyone hates me? I don't care.
Regina, please. Regina, stop! Oh!
Do you know what everyone says about you? They say that you're a homeschooled jungle freak who's a less hot version of me.
Yeah,
so don't try to act so innocent. You can take that fake apology and shove it right up your hairy...
And that's how Regina George died. No, I'm totally kidding. But she did get hurt.